Okay, so this is the Blacklight project for the garage, which you see right here, which is an utter mess. So we have two black fabric panels set up here side by side, which I'm considering this one panel at this point, with a 1x2 on the top that I've stapled the fabric to. And then I just have pieces of string hooking up to a hook here. And then I have a 1x2 on the bottom, which I have stapled it to just for weight. I thought about putting it on the edges, but then I don't think it's really necessary. This is just going to be suspended from the ceiling by hooks, and I think it'll be weighted down enough to where the image will be flat. So I start with the fabric pieces. This is just landscape fabric you can buy like at Home Depot. I try to get as thick as one as I can just so it's stronger and blacker. And then I go ahead and paint an image with gesso, which is what you prime a regular canvas for if you're going to paint a picture. I find that the gesso is necessary. I've tried to paint just on the black. It does work, it's just not as bright. I do have a white fluorescent paint that I've been spittling on there for stars. I'm not gonna gesso every little dot, that would be crazy. But it comes out pretty good. I kind of go over the dots a couple times just to make it a little more bright. But for the most part, I just gesso the areas that I'm going to paint because it is brighter and it seems to be just a much better image. I have tried at least one or two layers of gesso, and it really takes three. So I'll show you one layer that I've got going on this panel. This is one layer. This is almost dry. Almost. I think I can almost put the second layer on. And it really needs three. And it's funny because the container actually recommends three. So here's the gesso. And I think this, this is a gallon I got off of Amazon, and it was pretty reasonably priced. I think it was like 15, 20 bucks, something like that. And seems like a lot, but I'm going through, I think, about halfway already. I've done 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the fifth full panel with the two sides. And then this one over here is going to be the sixth. And I don't know how many I need quite yet. I'm gonna have a couple turns. It's gonna be a labyrinth space scene. So I'm gonna need more, I just don't know how many, and then I'm gonna need some half panels for some turns and such. But I will be painting the backside also, so I may not need as many panels as I think. Anyway, I'll show you my progress with this. I'm really excited. The fluorescent paint I've got works really well. I've already tested it in the Blacklight, and I think the trick-or-treaters are really gonna like it for the sci-fi theme this year. Okay, so here's that panel that I was showing you guys, and sorry, I can't cramp corners here in this garage, but it's almost finished painting. Just a really simple space scene, and then I dotted everywhere for the stars, which you can't really see, but you can see it in the black light. So it's actually it's pretty cool looking, kind of plain looking with daylight, but then with the black light it looks great. So I have several more panels of this to go, but it's really simple, really, you know, very, very simple scenes, but it's effective. And the black is just from, so there's a gesso that you saw, and then it's the fluorescent paint, and then the black is the Sharpie. I just go on there and I can draw and black out, and like those rocks that are in front of that light part of the planet down there, and that seems to be the fastest, and it blocks the light from the black light, and it gives that illusion. So here is this. I'll show you more soon. Okay, haunters, progress. So we have multiple stages for the blackout or blacklight panels. This is stage two with the second coat of gesso, needs the third coat and color. And this is the last stage down here where I had to paint the black on top of the color to kind of give more of the details. But this is a panel that's finished, just happens to be lying on the floor, and then there's a little panel there that's wrapped up. But you can kind of see what the colors look like after I add the color and then the black on top of it. And then behind here, there's a panel that's finished. I wasn't really liking the way I was using a Sharpie to kind of get the black details on top of the color. So I went ahead and took my black paint. I don't know why I didn't think about this before, but slapped the paint on top of it, and it really brought it out, I think, a lot better. And it looks very, very cool with the black light, with the lights out. So there is a panel that's finished, and then I have another panel over here. I think I've already shown you guys this one, but the entrance has kind of a zigzag kind of pattern with all the colors, kind of like the people are entering and then they're being transported into space. And so this is how the black light room maze is going to start, and then there's going to be a bunch of stars, and then they're going to have the celestial bodies all over and the continuing panels through it. So anyway, that's the progress. Oh, I thought you guys might want to see this. This is pretty cute. I made two Halloween games. Sorry, it's a little dark back here. Both my boys are in Cub Scouts, and they have a carnival every year. And so I made a couple of Halloween games. This one is the ring toss. And let me tilt it this way so you can see. It's the ring toss, and it's witch hats. I thought it was really, really cute online, so I went ahead and made it. And then here's the rings. They're just pool rings. And then they just throw it when this is lying down on the ground. The other game I've got is the eyeball toss. And this thing is kind of the same kind of idea, but it's these eyeballs that are pinned up there, and there's these little miniature cauldrons, and then I spray painted like goopy green on it, and so it looks like the goop is coming out of the cauldron, and then I made the eyeball toss at the bottom. So anyway, if I think about it, I will video the boys playing with these games during the carnival event, and then you guys can check it out. But I know you guys would appreciate that. Well, let me put these back. There we go. Okay, so that's that. Okay, so here's our final blacklight room. They're gonna enter in the garage from the back. And then they will see this first. And it's kind of supposed to be like a, you know, like a time warp or a black hole, or kind of transporting the attendees into space. So we have these really cool lines on both sides. And then I put these really cool, I love it, fluorescent tape down of different colors. It kind of just stretches the vision all the way down to the bottom. And so they're going to follow it, and then it's going to kind of go into this area right here. And I just realized I have to turn on the lights. Okay, so then they follow this line around the corner. If I have time, I will paint more stars in this corner, but I don't think so. So they're just gonna follow the floor. And then they turn the bend, and then they are now entered into space. And so I have both sides kind of lit up with, kind of neat the way I didn't really plan it this way, but I've got blue on one side and then I've got red on the other, and kind of a neat entrance way. Kind of like a starburst going on here. And I'm gonna go down the hallway here. And you see planets. And it came out pretty nice. And there's the
asteroids in the background. And then we've got another kind of celestial picture here. And then they can look down if they want to. And I've got like the tape broken up into stars on the floor. And so they'll see kind of, you know, Jupiter and some other planets and, I don't know, just kind of everything, any color or design I thought was cool. I just went ahead and painted it. And then they're gonna turn here and see, you know, kind of a variety of different planets. And I've got a UFO in the way because I can't put that on the ceiling, or on the roof rather. Yet we've had some super crazy wind going on here in the Bay Area in California, and that thing was just gonna blow right off the roof, so I have to wait a day or two for the weather to calm down and I'm able to put that back up there. So here it is, it's sitting right here, and I've got lights on it and everything, but it's just in here until I can get a chance to put it up. So I'm just gonna walk around and then we can see the rest of the designs, the comets and things. Actually pretty cool. I think people are gonna like it. Let's see. We've turned down this way and then you'll see more asteroids, and it's predominantly blue. And then go down here and you can see like the Enterprise from Star Trek. Hallway of stars, and then they will exit out this way, which is the small garage door, and then continue on through the haunt. So there you go, see it from the other direction. And of course I'll have some really cool music, and I've got all kinds of tracks from various sci-fi, you know, movies and TV shows like X-Files and Buck Rogers and anything I could find, and kind of mished it together with some kind of spacey sounds and, you know, whatever I could find. Put it in a playlist and I think it'll be fun to listen to while they're walking through this. And this is gonna have to be it. I am out of time. So I think it's fun. Took several hours to paint all this, but it was definitely worth it. I just wish I could do more. So anyway, that's it. You'll see it in the final walkthrough, daytime and nighttime, coming soon. But it is really close to Halloween. We got about a week left, and I gotta wrap this up pretty quick. So thanks for watching, and more coming. Oh, nice try, buddy. Nice.